Did you grow up expecting an inheritance?
Not at all, no. I'm one of nine children in a first-generation migrant family from India, and it simply wasn't on the radar. There was always an emotional safety net. There simply wasn't going to be a financial safety net. And so I think it made us all develop a very good work ethic and a sense of initiative to go and try to make our own way as well.
And your parents worked really hard, right?
They did. They lived a very comfortable life in India. They met at a country club. They had domestic staff, as many do in India. They came to Australia and used everything they had to establish our family in Perth. My father worked in the civil service, but endured a lot of racism in the 70s. I appreciate it's different now. And eventually left that and became a cleaner. My mother worked in a large hospital kitchen, so they did it tough, as so many do.
What was your housing like growing up?
Oh, we grew up in public housing called Homes West in WA. I think they purchased their home eventually for the princely sum of $46 a month.
Wow.
So they were like the Flintstones. They were there for years.
Your father passed in 2018 at the age of 94. Mm-hmm. Had you discussed inheritance with him?
We had. When he passed, he'd been battling dementia for some time. But before that, absolutely, we'd all encouraged him, all the children, had encouraged Mum and Dad repeatedly to just go and enjoy their money. We often said to them, it's because of you and your sacrifices that we're able to now provide for ourselves.
When your dad died, what did he leave you?
My parents worked many years. They paid 96 years of school fees,
wow,
which still staggers me, putting us all through private school. So they gave us those opportunities, and we were very encouraging of them to go out and enjoy it in their golden years. But I guess it's something primal that a parent wants to pass something on to their children, and Dad was lovingly determined to do that. We each received $500, and just to share it with you, my heart squeezes because it meant everything to him to do that. He was so lovingly determined to leave something to his children. And I feel that monetarily it was a modest inheritance, but metaphysically it was off the charts because there was not a day growing up that I felt unloved, unsafe. I'm sorry.
It's fine. Sounded like you grew up in the most supportive, loving household. So that gift of 500 must have felt even greater because of the sacrifices and because of the gifts you'd already been given, in a sense.
Very much.
Thank you, Alicia.